On the Medical Watch, a new stealth COVID variant. Just as cases of COVID-19 seem to be declining in the U.S., Omicron BA.2 is discovered, and it was identified right here in Illinois. Joining us now is Dr. Judd Hultquist, Associate Director at Northwestern Medicine's Center for Pathogen Genomics and Microbial Evolution. Doctor, thank you for being here. I think the first question everyone has is this new variant more easily spread?
Well, yeah, that's the concern and why we've been keeping an eye out for it. So what's important to know about this new variant called BA.2 is that it contains some additional mutations in addition to what Omicron traditionally has. And these new mutations that can make it up to 1.5 times more transmissible than the original Omicron.
Oh, boy. So with Omicron, a lot of people were vaccinated by the time it came here. It seemed not to make people as sick, yet so many more people died just because of the sheer numbers. Is that what you're concerned about with this variant?
Yeah, well, the difficult thing to know is exactly what happens to case numbers now. We've been really fortunate to see case numbers dropping really rapidly across the city and even parts of the rest of the state recently. And we want those numbers to keep dropping because, like you said, with an increase in case numbers, especially when so many people are getting infected, that means more people in the hospital and more people who are dying. Now, with a more transmissible variant coming in, we don't know if that's going to result in an additional surge of cases. So we've seen BA.2 enter other countries such as the UK, India, and Denmark. And we didn't really see a surge in cases, but the decline slowed down. We want to keep that decline going strong.
Traditionally, with other viruses, as we've seen them spread more rapidly, they get weaker. Is that at all happening with Omicron, especially with this BA.2?
Yeah, I would be hesitant to even say weaker. I think it's more accurate to say that we're better at protecting ourselves. Mm-hmm. And that both includes better public health measures that we adopt, you know, individually, washing our hands, wearing masks. But it also means better immunity through either vaccinations or through natural infection immunity.
Okay, let's talk about those vaccines. Are they going to work against BA.2?
The good news is, yes, if people are vaccinated and especially if they're boosted, it's shown very, very high efficacy protecting against BA.2, especially against severe disease.
So when people get tested, should they be asking what variant they have? It seems like knowledge is power in terms of trying to protect yourself, but so many people get a positive or a negative test result.
Yeah, one of the unfortunate things about current diagnostic testing is while it can tell you, do I have COVID or do I not have COVID, most of the time it can't really tell you which variant you have. And you really need to use specialized approaches, you know, like we do here at Feinberg School of Medicine, to try to understand exactly what variant it is that is causing the infection. So understanding that information can be helpful from a clinical perspective, but from a patient's perspective, unfortunately, not. The best thing to do is follow the advice of your doctor, follow the advice of the CDC.
So even if we don't know, is the state somehow tracking these different variants and who got what?
Yeah, absolutely. So our lab and hospitals across the state are coordinating very closely with the Chicago Department of Public Health to track which variants are prevalent at which times. And that's really, really useful information. So just to give you one quick example, the Omicron variant is known to be resistant to specific monoclonal antibody treatments that had previously been employed earlier in the pandemic to help patients with very severe disease. Well, against Omicron, those don't really work. So knowing which variant is circulating in a community can be really helpful from a clinical perspective as to what a clinician's best route of action for a given patient might be.
And that tells us how important the work is that you are doing. Thank you so much, Dr. Judd Hultquist.
Thank you.
Ray?
All right.